So let's start with the Xampp download. As on this website, you need to open this URL, and there you need to download this 5.6 latest version, which is right now available as shown here is 5.6.28. So we are going to download it, and this depends. As for the Linux machine, it is only for available for the 64-bit editions, so we need to download it. I am cancelling it because I already downloaded it on my machine. Hi, my name is Atul and you are watching Techobia. Today I am here with the series of the Linux where I am going to tell you how to install Xampp or LAMP on your Linux machine 64-bit edition for Mint or Ubuntu. Let's get started. So let's go to the console. In this entire video, I'm going to show you that how you can install only from the console without GUI. First of all, you need to change and make this file executable. Then you need to run this command so you can start the setup wizard. Once you initialize, then it will show you that what you want to do. Then simple, yes, we need Xampp developer files. And yes, and definitely the default directory should be like /op/lamp. So when we clicked on yes, so don't think this is the original time, because I 6x it for you. It will take some time on your machines. Be patient. Once it is done, then there are some major changes which we need to change. First of all, if you see, there is a htdocs folder, and if you see the default permission, which is only set for the root and root. First, I'm going to change its username and the group to my default username and group, which is qng131 in this case. You can run this command to get it executed. And then we are going to check it again, as you see. And by using this command, even subfolders and the subfiles also change to the same group. So now it's time to start the LAMP services. By this single command, all the three services will get started at the same time: Apache, MySQL, and Pro FTPD. So let's check the PHPMYADMIN, which is a very big problem in the case like if you are trying to access it on the network, because it is only allowed and accessible for the local machine. So right now I'm going to tell you the process that how you can make it accessible over the network. Whereas PHP successfully installed, and PHP we are checking at the PHP info page, which is showing us all the information. So this is a command which we need to run to make the PHPMYADMIN accessible on the network. Once this file is open, we need to change this local thing to all granted and make sure all the characters are small. Then save this file. It depends on your editor, what editor you are using. As here, I just opened this file in the nano. So you need to press Ctrl X and then hit enter to write this file. And now you need to restart the LAMP services. Now it is done. We are going to check our PHPMYADMIN page again. Sorry, my bad. My URL is 68.0. So if you see, PHPMYADMIN is open, and here we are looking at the warning that you are using the default username root and the password. If you are on a local network and your 3 and 4 guys are working, this is not important because everyone can access the PHPMYADMIN page easily. So now another thing is how you can change the files to set your username and group with the default group of the Apache. So here you need to find these files, and the httpd.conf file is the main file which is responsible for it. And there are several files available. I am showing you this original file. Whereas I made the changes in this file. And to be honest, this file is not working in this case, but you can see that I already made the changes to the user and the group. So then I found that the previous file, the first file, which is /etc, we need to edit this file. And once I was done with the edit of this file by making the change inside http.com, here user and group, I changed to my default user and default group so that I don't have to go to the FTP again and again. Even if I just directly go to the directory and I want to make the changes in the file, I can directly place the files inside the folder and I can directly make the changes inside those files, and there will be no permission issue for that. And even for the FTP, if you want to access this from the FTP, you need to edit this file. And there I'm going to change the user. Here you were looking at the Xampp user. Just change this user to your default username and even to the below. By this you will get the benefit, like when you are just logging with this username and the password which is default is Xampp, as it is its base64 notation. So if you are using this via the FTP, then like Xampp. Okay, I'm using SFTP, let me delete this. If you are deleting this and connecting it, right now you are directly inside the htdocs folder. And if you create any new file, anything, and if you check its username and the group, it is the same. Like qng131, qng131, so no username and the group name issues. Every file is created by this. And if inside the FTP, if you use SFTP and your username real password with port 22, you can access it as SFTP. So you can even access the home folder and can make changes anywhere by that. By this, you can secure your main folder and only provide the other users to access only htdocs inside your machine, whereas you can keep your all the directories secure with a different password, which is your username password, which has no connection with this Xampp FTP username. Even by using these settings, you can install Laravel on your machine. And even if you are a shell user, you can even use wget commands to download the CMS like WordPress and directly extract those, and there will be no issue because every permission is by default with your username and group. If you like this video, you know what to do, and please subscribe to the channel so you will be in touch whenever I will publish new video. Thank you for watching. Signing off for today. Bye bye.